Good morning, everybody. What's happening? What's going on? So I guess I checked in a little late today, but we just finished our quick little distance shakeout workout thing. 10 times 200 at somewhere below 35. Didn't really matter. First five were probably 33s. The other ones were 35 point, just to kind of do a cool down. Not cool down, but nice, easy finish to the day. Started with javelin this morning. I actually got video of that. I actually forgot to vlog this morning when I went to my lift. I actually went to lift with one of my friends at Snap Fitness. So we went early, we went like 7, which is kind of where I'm used to lifting. And then came here, did practice, and threw jab and ran a little bit. But yeah, overall, good day. Good start to the day.
Put a spell on you.
Okay, I want to talk a little bit about that javelin sequence you guys just watched. Oftentimes I show you guys videos, and they're cool little montages, but I don't actually break them down. In that javelin stuff, obviously I was not going from full approach. I was either walking to basically like a one step or going very slow, or I would walk into just a single crossover. The whole point of that is when I was throwing at USA's, in Des Moines, I would collapse on my left, and so my left knee would bend drastically, and it would cause me to kind of collapse and top the javelin or throw it under or really yank on it, and it just wasn't a good javelin throw. I only ended up throwing 55 meters or something like that, which is 6 meters below my personal best, and I'm in fairly good shape right now. I should be throwing my personal best. So to fix that, if you watch my left leg in almost all these videos versus if you were to go back and watch any of my other javelin videos or anything like that, my left leg is going to be a lot straighter, meaning that I'm hitting a good block and it's allowing my hips to actually rotate, which is going to cause my arm to come through faster and everything to just get around a little bit quicker and put a little bit more force in that javelin. So oftentimes I know that I don't break things down, but javelin's one of my favorite events, and I've been watching Vetter, Roller, Johannes, Hoffman, the three large German javelin throwers. Vetter has an insane block. Hoffman, I think is the other guy's name, kind of moves over the top of his block very quickly, but his leg stays straight. And then Roller has kind of your typical block. Vetter is very extreme, obviously unbelievably strong guy, so he can get away with it. Me, not super strong guy, I need to be able to build on it. So we saw a mistake that happened, and I guess this is a learning experience for everybody. Even though you might be the best on your team, you might be the best athlete at your school, there's always a time and a place to go back to the basics. This is something that you would do in high school, elementary school, when you're first learning how to throw the javelin. You walk into a jab throw, plant, th- throw, plant, turn, throw, plant, turn, throw, plant, turn, throw. And I've thrown 6180. So I've thrown over 200 feet, over 60 meters. I can kind of consider myself a pretty good javelin thrower. So when I am at this level and I see something wrong, the first thing I do, the first thing me and my coach do is go back to the basics. So we went back to literally walking into a javelin throw, making sure I plant on that left foot, and then hitting a good block, keeping that leg straight as possible without any pain or injury, and then moving over the top of that block with my right hip and my right hand. Yeah, so I wanted to explain why basically the whole video was about javelin and why the whole sequence was basically just the same throw over and over again. And it's just that I can feel that same thing. Gradually add a crossover, add another crossover until you build that strength to where you can continue to carry that speed all the way through the javelin throw. That's pretty much going to be it for today's video though, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. I'm super passionate about javelin. It was the first track event that I ever learned. My sister learned it when she was in elementary school from one of our high school coaches here in Bend, and I would always just tag along for the practices, and that's how I learned how to throw it. So that was actually my first track event, and I've loved it ever since. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope this wasn't a super boring video. If you're a javelin thrower, I hope that it was somewhat insightful and somewhat enjoyable to watch. Even if you're not a javelin thrower, javelin's probably the most fun event to watch outside of pole vault. But hey, look at that. You get to watch both of them if you watch the decathlon. So, new favorite event. Remember, be nice people. Don't hurt yourself. Don't hurt others. Slow down. Don't dance so fast. And I will talk to you guys all tomorrow. Okay, bye. How cool is it that I've posted... This is the 12th video. So, I've gotten to say I'll see you guys tomorrow and actually meant it 12 straight days. I'm kind of pumped about that. I hope you guys are too. Also, random thing. If you've watched this long, you're going to be one of the few people that I actually consider for this. I want to do either Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday, sometime later in the week, so that I don't get bogged down with trying to vlog every single day. I want to do a Q&A video. So I want to take like 3 or 4 questions that I answer for that day. So let me know whether you guys want it to be Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. That would be the Q&A video. And then throw me some questions in the comments. Hit me up on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, whatever you have, or whatever you follow me on. And then, yeah. Love to hear what you guys have questions for me going into the Thorpe Cup, about USAs, about my life in general, and just, yeah. And happy to be back. Daily vlogging. Who'd have thought? I'll talk to you tomorrow.